Welcome to my channel. I am so excited to have you here with me. I was like, what can we do for a third stream today? And one of my subscribers sent me this last night. Well, they said, you need to check out this video. Because they say, Jessa says she loves her house, blah, 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 blah. Not really telling me what was in the video. And I get about 5 minutes into this video and I'm like, want a dry heave because I cannot believe she put this on YouTube. Okay, so Jessa Seewald is the what, third daughter? Josh. Yeah, third daughter, fifth child of Michelle and Jim Bob Duggar. She is the control freak, the opinionated, the hard to control, according to what Michelle said when she was a child. She famously decided to have her bridesmaids wear dresses that she ordered online. And then when they actually tried them on, they fit terribly and she didn't care. She made them wear them anyway. And she only served ice cream at her reception because she just was cheap. That was literally like her excuse. So she's a thrifty person, which is totally fine. That's nobody's knocking the thrift, but she's done house tours before. So the house that she lives in, if you remember, is actually the same house that was gifted to her by her father when she and Ben were courting and they moved into shortly after they got married. Since they got married only, what, 5 years ago, they have three kids now in a two-bedroom home that is filled to the brim. And it's this house tour, she did sort of a before and after where the house was absolutely filthy and then they cleaned it up afterwards. But it's the before part that I'm like, I couldn't even stand it. So Spurgeon was taking everyone on a house tour, okay? And he walked into the bathroom and it was cute. I mean, he was like narrating everything. So I can't hate on Spurgeon because he's a super cute little boy. And he was definitely like playing it up for the camera. But watch what happens.
This is the potty. So if we need to go to the potty, while this potty's not here, we can't go to the bathroom. And we'll just have to pee all over us.
Oh my goodness, tell us what you did just a little bit ago with the roll of toilet paper.
Rolled all of the toilet paper in there. That's so bad.
Yeah. Spurgeon was using the toilet.
Why? Why?
And he had unrolled the whole roll of toilet paper into the toilet. So that's, I don't know what we're going to do. We're going to have to put some gloves on and scoop it out or something. I think it'll probably clog it up if we try to flush it down.
Why?
What's this over here?
Okay.
Okay,
so she went in there to wipe his bottom, which isn't abnormal. A lot of us moms do that for our kiddos. But she's like, keeps panning in on the dirty toilet, which has poopy in it. Like, why, Jessa? Why would you do that? Nobody on YouTube needs to see that. Now I have to share it because it's so grody. Okay, so then there's this other part where, hold on. There's Henry just standing on the counter.
Every night we love baths. And we want to take them.
Okay, no, it's not every day. Time. Okay, let's get down. On the counter without permission. Ooh, okay. What about that basket right there?
Where we put our toys. If we don't put them right there, we have no toys to play in.
They do have toys in their house, so she got a bird feeder for Henry, but it's confirmed there are some, at least some toys in their home, okay? Now, the next thing is we're going to go into, hold on, their bedroom.
So what's on Teddy? What's he wearing there?
A diaper, so he won't pee in my bed.
Oh, okay. Is that a napkin with some tape on it? Oh, that's a beautiful diaper. What are all those toys in the corner of your room? Is that where we store the tracks?
Uh-huh. And, okay. And if I don't have any friends, if I say, Daddy, I don't have any friends, then Daddy will say, hey, you have Teddy here and Doggy here.
That's right. So this is Henry's bed. Henry sleeps on this queen size bed, which is also our guest bed. And, oh, don't jump on the bed.
My question here is, why does Henry get the big bed and Spurgeon's put into a bed that's like literally for a toddler and Spurgeon looks like a big kid for his age? I think he's four, almost five. Why is he in a tiny toddler bed and little guy is on the main humongous queen size bed? And not only that, but they have to share their tiny bedroom with Ben, for his office.
Books and such that we need to put away. Ben's laptop. Yeah, so this is Ben's desk.
I'll
this is where Ben studies.
Doesn't float. So if we do that, it comes back down.
Yeah, because it doesn't have any helium in it, does it?
So it's filled with two bookshelves full of, like, books, their beds, and then, like, so Ben studies where they sleep. I would love to know how that works. Here, let me show you the kitchen. This is in the beginning of the video.
There are certain things in our dining room, on our chairs. I cut my thumb while making sweet potato fries, so I have a band-aid on my thumb. So we've got clothes hanging in the dining room, drying. They should be dry by now because I left them here all night. Okay, and here's the living room, Spurge. Tell us about what you guys did in the living room this morning.
So, it's really not that hard to buy a clothes dryer, like a clothes rack, Jessa. You don't have to use your kitchen table for your clothing, but whatever. And I don't care about the messiness. The toilet was like literally over the top for me. There was this one other part where they're in his bedroom. And she's decided that they're going to just keep their Christmas tree up in their bedroom.
The bed's not made yet. We've got pack and play. We've got craft supplies on top of the dresser. We've got there's some stuff we need to return. Hey, how about we turn on the lights in here so we can see better?
Okay.
It's been raining out there, so we won't get to play outside today. We were outside yesterday, and the day before it was like 70 and 76 degrees, and now it's back down in the 40s. And here's our beloved Christmas tree. We weren't ready to put it away, so we just brought it in to Mom and Dad's room. Spurge, find that cord and I'll plug it in. Here, give me the cord. Oh yeah,
so
I like you in the living room too.
So maybe we should go back in the living room, because it stayed in here for hundreds of years too.
Okay, well, we'll consider it.
Okay. So I didn't say, someone said in the chat, like, the house isn't filthy. I never said the house was filthy. I said it was messy, but I don't care. I said I don't care that it's messy or if that it even appears filthy to me. The toilet was filthy. But they do clean up, and I get it that kids happen and that kind of stuff. But after the math, there's this part where she's taking everyone through. She shows people how to clean everything. Where is it? Oh, this is weird. This is like right by their toilet. Hold on. So they go into their room.
Two people, one sink. Mirror is still not clean. We'll get to that later. Yep.
Oh, she cleaned the toilet, you guys. Yay!
Yeah, it was kind of nasty. No more throwing whole rolls of toilet paper in there, okay?
Okay.
Look at these bizarre sketches that they put. Like, she put these bizarre sketches on the wall where you're going to the bathroom that apparently Ben made.
Whenever he was 14. Thank God.
Okay. So she puts this on the wall, which is like a verse from Romans, which again, right when you're going to the toilet, you know, learning to be a good person. So you just, you know, constantly indoctrinating yourself with the Bible in this house, which is fine. I guess it's just weird placement for these pictures next to the toilet. And the questionable sketch. I don't know what to feel about that. Anyways, at the very end, she talks about the house being small, and let me just fast forward that so you can hear it. Oh, and there's the bedroom. It's all cleaned up. But the biggest thing is that there's no place for Ivy. They clean up the bedroom, and they put together everything, and, like, Henry's bed is made, and Spurgeon's bed is made, and their bedroom gets cleaned up, and everything gets put off. But, like, Ivy doesn't have a bed. There's not a crib set up for her. There's not a bassinet set up for her. There's literally no place for her to sleep, which freaks me out because that might mean she sleeps with her, which is a humongous no-no, according to the American Academy of Pediatrics. You should never be doing that. Jessa, where is your daughter sleeping? There's a changing table, but not a crib. So they don't have a lot of space, which people have small houses all the time. But typically you would have a spot for your daughter to sleep safely.
Our house is still a pretty good fit and pretty good size for...
Here, I'm gonna just...
Feeling cramped. And I feel like our house is still a pretty good fit and pretty good size for the five of us. The kids are still so young that we can make it work pretty easily. And also, I think I'm just really sentimental because then we'll talk occasionally about, well, we're gonna need to move to a bigger house at some point. And like, I know, but I just love our house. I mean, this is where so many of our firsts have happened. This is our first house to buy. This is where all of our kids have been born and raising them. And it's just like so many memories cooped up within these walls. It's gonna be really, really hard for me to part with this house, but I know we can't live here forever, so I'm just gonna have to mentally prepare myself that, hey, one day we are going to move. But for now, I love it. I love having a tiny house. I love how easy it is to keep it clean. And I just love the sweet memories we're making here together as a family.
Okay. So, it's a cute house. It's a very cute house. The toilet was super dirty. Spurgeon was apparently very adorable. She likes the house because of the memories that it gives her, which is completely fine and all of that. If she has someone in chat said that she might have a pack and play, others said that people co-sleep. I don't want to talk about that because it gets people very upset. But again, it's not recommended by the American Academy of Pediatrics. It is not advised as a safe sleep measure, and we know that co-sleeping can result in a lot of very bad things. So, but I'm not here to debate that. Anyways, the point of this is that she said that she really loves her house, and then I was like kind of wondering, when she moved in to that house, the one thing that she said was that Jill and Derek got the bigger house from her mom and dad, and she said that Jill and Derek could afford the utilities and the payments and everything that went along with that. She said that she and Ben, because they weren't working, could afford the smaller house. Now, the smaller house isn't, I mean, my first house was around the same size as that house. It's not a bad house for a small family, as long as everyone has space and there's a place for everyone to sleep. But then I got to thinking, maybe part of the reason why she really likes this house is because she has absolutely no payment. When I looked online at the records, she actually was gifted this property by her grandmother, who I'm assuming it went through Jim Bob, and they only paid $1 for it. So when a warranty deed shows $1, that will typically mean that it's a gift. According to here, it says, if a property is being given as a gift or transferred without consideration, you will still need to fill out the consideration amount on your warranty deed. In these circumstances, the standard consideration is $10. Jim Bob recently did the same thing with Joy and Joanna and Austin and gifted them a home for $10 as well. It appears that Jessa and Ben got this house for $1. So there's incentive for them to like this house because it's free and it's cheap, and neither one of them appear to have jobs. Ben is apparently in school and works sometimes as a handyman, but he's definitely not fully employed. And then Jessa is a stay-at-home mother that apparently is uploading more on Instagram and on YouTube, so attempting to make some money via influencing. So overall, I think it's a super cute house. I'm assuming part of the reason why they love it too is the low price that they paid for it, as well as the fact that they don't have a lot of bills with this house. So the one thing I could absolutely have done without in this entire video was that dirty toilet. So, we don't know where Ivy sleeps. That's the big question. So they have a free house with no mortgage. They just have to pay utilities and food and whatever. This again was gifted to them. They are on the deed. So if you go look at the property records, you can see what the property is worth, how much the taxes are. It's all in Jessa and Ben's names. So that's their tiny house. They don't have space for Ivy, but at some point she admits they're going to outgrow, they're going to have to get something new, which begs the question is, which one of them is going to get the job? Is Ben going to finally get a job? Is Ben going to finally stop just like being the handyman homeschooler that isn't getting paid by Jim Bob and like make a career for himself? I'm always trying to like wonder, like the boys have jobs, right? Like Jed and like a couple of his boys help run one of the car dealerships. John David is I believe an EMT or a paramedic. I can't remember which one. Josh used to have a car lot. And then I don't remember what Joseph does. Joseph and Josiah also work somewhere for their dad. But Ben literally doesn't have a job. So there's that. So this house works perfectly for them because it's essentially free. All right, you guys. So Josh and Anna did live in that house before along with Grandma Duggar. What are your thoughts? Did you like it? Was the toilet gross? Do you wish she wouldn't have shown that? I do. Let me know what your thoughts are in the comments below. Bye, guys.